Hello students, in this video I will demonstrate how we can write a CSS code and how what effect it will have on the web page. Now I have a code here, that is in this code I have a h1 tag, so I would like to zoom this just a minute so that it will be very clear to you. Zoom, increase the size here. Some problem, just a minute, I will just zoom back. Okay, now let us discuss about the simple basic HTML concept here. See, then how when we implement the CSS, what happens with that? That also we will discuss. Now here you see we got the h1 tag, we have defined h1 tag and we have defined p tag, and we have not defined any color to the body. In this we will apply all these attributes or designing factors using CSS, and we will see how it works. First we will see a normal page, what we see in the browser. So when you write a code like this, you will get a HTML page in this fashion. So this is the heading, that message I have typed using my Sublime Text, and p is a paragraph. These two attributes I use. Now I will use a cascading style on body and h1 tag, and how it is done we will discuss. So whenever you want to write a cascading style sheet, you can write it in this as a separate page, or you can write it within the same HTML page. That is called as an inline. Now I will use that method. What is inline and what is external, we will discuss it later. Here in this head, see, usually what we are writing it in the body. In the head we have to write now. Here you can see there is a tag called as a style. Okay. So directly you can see here, type equal to cascading style sheet. Yeah, this is what it is coming. But it is not necessary. Even if you remove this, it can be an issue. Now I will just write a code into this. First what I will do is, we will change the background color. We know the attribute what we have here is the body. So for that body attribute, what I will do is, I will write a code. Body, so automatically it comes. Then we have to use the curly braces. Correct. And now I want to change the background color. Background color. Here you can see the attribute here, background color. Automatically it comes if you are using Sublime Text. What I will do is I will use green yellow, that lemony color. Okay, after that semicolon is coming automatically. Just I will check how it works. See how the code is written. You see in the syntax we have seen what is the syntax. I will just demonstrate it to you. It will be better if you, yeah, here. So this is the selector. So here I have taken body as a selector. Then comes the declaration. I have taken color, that background color I have taken blue, here it is. So only one declaration I have taken. So I have taken background color is colon. Here you should not use equal to, you have to use colon, two dots. Okay, now, and here semicolon. This is colon and this is semicolon. So in case you have a doubt, I will be sharing the notes with you. There you can check it. There is a colon and there is semicolon. So this one CSS I have written. So I will save the file. I will use Ctrl S. Save the file, and I will check in the browser and I will refresh it. So color is changed, correct? I have not used this attribute background color in the body part, which I have already explained with you. So if you define it in one page, same you can copy it in another page, or you can, if I define one CSS and you can link it to many HTML pages. So I will show you that later how it is done. Next I want to make some or I want to create a cascading style for H1. So for that, it's a very simple concept. Here I have to write H1. Now I will use H1. Here I will use for H1. See, I am taking the attribute as a H1. Okay. Now what I will do is I will write a just take it on the next line so that it will be clear. Then I will use a curly brace here. Okay, then color colon, automatically it is coming blue. Brown I will use. Okay, then I will save the file and I will check it in the browser. So the color is changed to brown. Even size also you can define, in case you want to define the size. Okay, you can define the size. I will set the margin. There is no margin here, correct? Now what I will do is I will set the margin. So here after semicolon I have to write margin left, left, right, top, bottom, you can check the margin. On the paper you are having a margin, no? So here you can set 50px. I will take px means pixel, 50px. I will save the file and I will execute. Here is it, you can make the margin. This is how you can define the CSS and you can use it. So this was basic video for designing defining the CSS. Later one by one, step by step, we will discuss or we will learn how we can implement the CSS in the different HTML pages, which is inline or external HTML pages. Thank you for watching this video.